Welcome again. Right now we are at John chapter 5 verses 1 through 14. And this is the story of Jesus healing at a pool near Bethesda. Let's start out with verse 1. After these things, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now I want to point out here that Jesus always celebrated the Jewish feasts because he was Jewish. He was 100% Jewish. Not only was he Jewish, but he was a Jewish rabbi. So don't forget, Jesus was 100% Jewish, and he celebrated all of the Jewish feast days and holidays. Verse 2. Now in Jerusalem, by the Sheep Gate, there is a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of those who were sick, blind, lame, or paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at certain times into the pool and stirred up the water. Whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was healed of whatever disease he had. I'll stop here for a second. I want to point out as well that this particular story is very interesting in that we have someone else healing instead of Jesus, okay? Here was an angel. So it was a supernatural thing that was happening. An angel would come and stir the pool up, and the first one down into the pool would be healed. Now notice, as we read on, that Jesus never had a problem with this. He never said, oh no, it's not me healing. It's not, you know, this is not of Jesus. This is not of me. This is an angel, and, you know, I think you better be careful here. As a lot of people would say today, if, for example, people saw angels, or if an angel came to a certain place or a certain church or whatever the case may be, people would say, well, is it of God, you know? Here, Jesus did not question. He had no problem with the fact that an angel was coming to the pool to stir the water and healing people, okay? And so, you know, there's a lot of things that happens in the scriptures. You know, even in the Apocrypha, and we're going to get to this as well. There are a lot of things that happen. A lot of, you might say, weird, or you might say unusual things that happens when angels come. Angels can use anything. You know, we look at in other parts of the Apocrypha that an angel used a fish, or an angel used this, or an angel used that. Different things you might say is very weird. Here we have an angel that used a pool of water to heal. He came down, stirred the pool of water, and the first one in was healed. Now, obviously, there's a lot of questions here. Why weren't they all healed? Okay, why does the pool not even exist today where people still get healed when they go there? Jesus never had a problem with the angel, and he never stopped the fact that the angel came and stirred the waters. So let's continue. Verse 5. A certain man was there who had been sick for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had been sick for a long time, he asked him, "Do you want to be made well?" What a question for, you know, someone who's been waiting for 30 some odd years, you know. Do you want to be made well? The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no one to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I'm coming, another steps down before me." Jesus said to him, "Arise, take up your mat and walk." Immediately the man was made well and took up his mat and walked. Now, here again, you look at the different methods that Jesus used to heal people. He didn't lay his hands on him. The man didn't have to touch him in any way. You know, like the woman with the issue of blood. Didn't happen that way. Here, Jesus just spoke the word. And Jesus didn't say, you know, what a lot of preachers would say today is, you know, be healed. You know, sometimes he didn't. Here he didn't. He spoke as if the man was already healed. You know, arise, take up your mat and walk. Like, and the guy just realized, hey, I'm already healed. So Jesus kind of stepped ahead of the game, so to speak. He didn't perform any particular healing ritual. just by faith, by the faith of Jesus himself, the man was healed. And Jesus just basically said, more or less implying, you're already healed, take up your mat and walk. So very interesting that Jesus would heal in this manner. He healed in all different ways, okay? Also notice that I don't think there's any place anywhere in the scriptures where Jesus actually prayed for someone to be healed. In other words, he didn't say, oh, Father in heaven, I ask you that you would heal this man, or I ask you that there would be power that would flow out of me to heal this man. He didn't at all. He didn't pray that way at all. Notice that, because a lot of people pray that way today. He didn't pray that way at all. He went light years ahead of that kind of stuff, okay? So just keep that in mind. Now, it was the Sabbath on that day. So the Jews said to him who was cured, it is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry the mat. I also want to point out here, these Jews, okay, that really weren't all that Jewish in a way, because they added to the Torah, okay? They thought that it was, you know, wrong for this man to carry his mat. Jesus said to the man, arise and take up your mat and walk, okay? So you need to understand that just because some of these other Jews says, oh no, it's not lawful for you to do that in the Sabbath, doesn't mean that what they said was true. It's not true that it was not lawful, okay? The truth is, it was lawful, or else Jesus wouldn't have commanded the man to do that. Jesus would never command anybody to sin against God, okay? So the problem was not that Jesus was breaking the Sabbath. He never, ever did. The problem was that the people, the Jewish people and the Jewish leaders, misinterpreted or overinterpreted the scripture, overinterpreted the Torah, you know, as they still do today in many ways, how they say they build a fence around the Torah. They go too far in certain things and not enough in other things, okay? So let's go on. He answered them, he who made me well said this to me, take up your mat and walk. Then they asked him, who is the man who said to you, take up your mat and walk? But he who was healed didn't know who it was, for Jesus had withdrawn, a crowd being in the place. Once again, here we got a situation where Jesus was unknown. The man didn't know who Jesus was. Okay, so it's not like the man had any faith at all. Okay, it was all just the faith of Jesus that performed this miracle. This man didn't need any faith at all in Jesus because he didn't even know who Jesus was. Okay, once again, this is to show you that there are different exceptions to the rules and there are different ways of healings and miracles, you know, as opposed to, you know, you got a lot of people today, especially in certain Christian circles, who say, you know, it's got to be done this way. You got to confess, and you got to pray this way, you know, or you got to have this kind of faith. That's not the truth. That's not the way it was here. That's not the way it was with this man and others as well in the scriptures. If you really look at it, you really read it for what it really says, and you really start asking questions, you'll see that not everybody that was healed by Jesus or the disciples had faith because they didn't even know what was going on. A lot of them, they didn't even know what to expect, okay? Let's go on. Verse 14, afterward, Jesus found him in the temple and said to him, behold, you are made well. Sin no more so that nothing worse happens to you. Wow, this is absolutely awesome, okay? This is awesome because Jesus, once again, he did it in later on in John chapter 8 as well, but here is another instance of Jesus commanding someone to sin no more. Notice, Jesus said, sin no more. He didn't say, You're human. I understand. There's no one perfect. You're all going to sin. You know, therefore, at least try not to sin. No. He said, sin no more. Okay? So mark that down and remember it. John chapter 5. And by the way, I'm just going to give you a little preview. John chapter 8 as well, where Jesus is recorded as saying, sin no more. So once again, thank you for listening, and may God enlighten the eyes of your understanding and give you great revelation as you call upon Him. Seek His face. He will show you great and mighty things. In the name of Yeshua, thank you.